Who would pity the drunken brute that struck a helpless man, that robbed and nearly killed for drink a poor and crippled man? And who was this unfeeling wretch, that rascal, Fighting Dan? Though nearly dead, the cripple lived to limp down to the court, and there described his foul attack and told how he was hurt. The sentence that Dan got that day was anything but sport. For days he waited in the jail till one day to his ward, the turnkey came and told him he was wanted in the yard. Soon he was stripped and fastened up, gan at it, hit him hard. And so they did, they hit him hard, and Dan turned very pale, though seldom frightened of a man. The cat soon made him quail. He yelled, but hurt his feelings so, this being flogged in jail. He cried for mercy, mark the words, for mercy at each stroke. But had he any mercy for the man he tried to choke? No, not a bit, not even if his victim's neck he broke. No pity for the hardened wretch, no sympathy or fear. With our many like him, and we don't want them here. That some would commit any crime, aye, murder, for their PR. Going out of my senses.
Oh, Bella, I must be going out of my mind writing a poem like that. You should have seen the faces, filled with hate. Mistress Fenwick looked as if she'd like to do the flogging herself. She did. Yeah, her eyes were gleaming at the prospect. I wouldn't mind, but they know as well as you do who I mean by fighting Dan. Old Dan Thompson. Why, I know he's an old toper and it's been the ruin of him. But could you flog him, Bella? He's like a bairn. He's light. We cannot have him gathering round murdering folks. But those good Templars, they looked as if they'd like to flog him every day of their lives if they had their way. It's the last of right for them! I'm trying to get back on that music hall stage if it kills us. I might. Well, we aren't coughing at the moment. It's going to kill us in a half.
What's your letter, lassie boy? It's grand to be back here with you again and feeling on top of the world. And what's better, I've got a brand new number for you. Aha, yes, dedicated especially to Nelly Walsh, who used to live next door to us. Why, you didn't mind lending a neighbour a cup of sugar or a half a loaf from time to time. But Nelly, she was knocking at my door every